You can put any question related to any question, any problem which you are experiencing in Annamaya Kosha. We will apply this truth. And one more thing, if you have questions, do not keep it, do not hide, open it, so that we can throw some light on that. Just as I told you in the first session, the introduction session, you can take my help, that's also your potential. And if you don't take, you are not using your potential completely. You are not using the potential. Let you use all your potentiality. Let you open up completely. Unless you put the questions, I won't be able to exactly give you the customized truth. Now I have given the truth in a generalized way. If you put your questions, if you open your problems, we can customize it. We can throw more light on that. Actually, when I designed this, when I was thinking about this Dhyanasmarana, I thought I'll design a program where I don't have to speak much. I am tired of speaking. In last 3 years, 4,000 hours of DVD cassettes we have, recorded DVDs. 4,000 hours of my lectures in last 3 years. We have a huge archives. I don't know what all I have spoken. And still they are not able to catch up with it. As on now, they published only 100 volumes. Only 100 volumes have come out in 10 languages. By this, in the end of this year, they are expecting 200 volumes to come out. Anyhow.
Swamiji, the continuity of the pain seems to create the shaft rather than the continuity of the thoughts.
No.
I'm not able to.
Please be very clear. Continuity of the shaft only is, you see, unless you create the shaft, you will not even identify it is a pain. You see, something is happening, for example, something is happening in your stomach. You will not call that as a pain unless you bring your memories of earlier same experiences which you put in the file titled pain.
So
10 years ago which happened in your stomach, 9 years ago which happened in your stomach, 8 years ago which happened in your stomach, all those memories you have put in a file and put a big title, pain, stomach pain, and kept in your brain, in your corner. The moment something starts happening in you, you pick up that file. Unless you pick up that file, you will not even get the title pain. Be very clear, the very first word itself is from the shaft. One more thing, this may look like mystical, but let me be honest, Patanjali says very clearly, any pain can be used as a door to enlightenment. Actually, I was shocked. How can pain be, at the time of pain, you only shout, oh God, God. How can it be used as a door to enlightenment? He says, do not label. Patanjali is a great scientist. He's a great scientist. Do not label. Just look what is going on. Just like how a child, small child, sees something new with all excitement and curiosity. Same way, just look what is happening. Just see. You will understand two things. First thing, your body is rejuvenating itself, reconstructing itself. That process only you are calling it as pain. That's the first thing. Next thing, when you don't label that as a pain, that feeling, you don't have to fight with that feeling. When you don't fight with that feeling, you are not fighting with the rejuvenation process itself. You are encouraging self-healing. You are helping self-healing. When you label that as a pain, not only you are fighting with the self-healing process, a reconstruction process, rejuvenation process, when you fight, you elongate the process and have more pain. When you do not fight, you may think, oh, only when you have pain, you will understand all these things, Swamiji. Please be very clear, it is not that I never had any pain, or it is not that I don't have any pain. If If you sit in my chair and see, do the job, then you will understand. Hours together. At least here only 2 days workshops. In India, 4 days workshop. Any workshop is 4 days. Average 18 hours I sit. Anybody who has done NSP in India? There are witnesses. 18 hours I sit in the same pose. Of course, here chair is little comfortable. In India, chairs are not like this. And one more thing. All American chairs are made for back pain. That's an important thing. See, whenever I sit in the wooden chair, I never feel anything. I don't feel any pain. In India, that wooden asanas, that straight one, this way and another one this way, horizontal plane and one vertical wooden thing. You are completely balanced. But maybe some lobby, two lobbies company, the people who are creating the chair and back pain medicine producers, who knows? Who knows what is happening here? But these chairs are all made for back pain, that much is sure. Anyhow, understand, it's not that I don't have any pain or anything. When I travel 18 hours in the flight, I do have the pain. I do experience. Of course, I don't label that as a pain. I just relax and look into it. Even before labeling, I look into it. What is it? And the same way, fatigue. When the fatigue starts, look into it. People who live around me, they know, morning when I come out of my room, the face and the voice, it will be same when I go back to my room after 20 hours. Not magic, not because of enlightenment. People think, oh, you are enlightened because of that, nothing. Be very clear, it is not because of any magic or enlightenment. Just look into it. Do not create shaft. This is the only simple technique. All you need to do is, do not create shaft, which is not there. Just remember, you are unclutched. And do not create shaft. The fatigue which you felt yesterday, the fatigue which you felt 1 year ago, the fatigue which you felt 2 years ago, they are no way connected to each other. They are independent incidents. Something came up, happened, over. But you label them and keep them all in a safe file for future reference. For future reference. How they keep in the hospitals? Just like that, you can have a file. I have a chronic fatigue problem. Big file. 7 o'clock means I'll be tired. 8 o'clock means I can't do anything more than that. After 8:15, if somebody asks me anything, I'll shout at them. I'll be tired. You have a big file. And you refer that file and always fulfill that file. Because only when you fulfill that file, you feel you exist. Otherwise, you feel your identity is shaken. You are not the same person. Somehow, you want to believe you are the same person every day. Be very clear. For 7 years ago, the person who existed in your name, and today who is existing in your name, these two are not the same person. Understanding, maturity, of course maturity never happens, that is different. At least age, information, all these things are totally different. But somehow you try to retain the identity. You don't trust, you also grow. And you don't trust, others grow. Of course, you don't trust, others grow, that is okay. That I can understand. You don't trust, you don't even trust that you are also growing. You don't trust, you can change the fatigue. Even if you have felt the fatigue 1 year ago, now there is every possibility you can update yourself. Your body might have overcome. You may not have that problem now. You are not interested in trusting that. You wanted to retain the identity. You can sacrifice anything for identity. That is why you try a very cunning, very polite but cunning game. This whole thing is just the game which you are playing. You may be thinking, Swamiji, When somebody comes, actually it happened. One person came to me with a chronic headache and he was complaining. I said, it is all in your mind. Why don't you give me little time to explain and try to understand, and then it will disappear. He says, when I come with the pain, instead of consoling me, you are saying this all in my mind. It's a deep disrespect to me. And I told him, please understand, it may look like deep disrespect. And people feel really offended when I say it is in your mind, because their identity is attacked. I'm straight away attacking their identity. See, you may feel offended, but what I am saying is truth. Let it be very clear. I can console you. That's not a big thing. Oh, you will become all right. You are great. You are a nice person. Don't worry. I'll heal you. All these things are okay. And one more thing, let me be very clear, open. Now I am opening another one business secret. Healing is nothing but giving you one more shaft. You have one shaft. You start believing somehow you have the body. That itself is a great lie. You come with that big lie. First lie, you have a body. Second lie, you have a disease in that body. Now somehow, I manage to take that one lie and replace another one lie. You have the healed body, that's all. And you heal yourself. Be very clear. It's purely playing with lies. Somehow I take that one lie that you have diseased body. Basic lie is you have a body. That's the first lie. Because you don't have a body. That is the truth. You may play with this body, but you don't have this body. You are playing with this body. Or you decided to play with this body. Anyhow, that is the first lie. The second lie, you have a diseased body. That is the second lie built on the first lie. When you come to me, actually second level, third level lies can be easily operated and opened. The first level lie is the difficult thing. The second level, third level lie, they are all superficial lies. It's almost a simple belief. It's very easy to change it. I just take that lie and replace this lie. You have a healed body, over. And you feel, oh, Swami has done a great help for me. Let it be very clear, this whole thing is myth. You are playing with some lies, so I play with some more lies, over. And let us ask another one question. All right, you come with a knee pain, I heal. You think that once for all you are healed, I made your whole knee with the steel. In 10 days you will have same pain. You will have the pain. If you don't change your mental setup, you will bring that pain back. Because your mental setup which is bringing the disease. Your mental setup which is bringing the disease. Unless we go to the depth and touch the core, I have always seen when people do meditation and have the healing, once for all they are healed. They never get the disease back. But people who come to me for healing, I tell them, why don't you come for a meditation program? They think, oh, you just heal me, Swamiji. I don't want to meditate and all. They just want the energy from me, but they don't want to listen to what I am saying. Then I tell them, all right, I have no problem. Let you be healed. They will be healed because of that energy. But it won't stay permanently. Because unless the deeper transformation happens, what can happen? You will bring that same disease back in 10 days. 10 days is too much, I think. You will bring it back because you are carrying the same mind. But if you also work with the mind, if you also cooperate with me with the meditation, anything which happens can be permanent. It can stay with you because you understand the truth. You start unclutching yourself. Any meditation can be called as meditation only if it gives you the experience of being unclutched. You may not know the word. If it just gives you the experience, then it can be called as meditation. Unless it gives you the feeling or experience of being unclutched, it can't be called as spiritual technique. One important thing, especially Western mind will be shaken with this truth, because Western mind is trained to believe you are nothing but your mind. At least in the East, from the beginning they know, even though they don't realize, there is unconscious belief, there is something more than mind exists. There is something more than mind exists. You are Atman, Brahman. You don't understand what is Brahman or Atman, that is different. But there is one more word inserted into you, which is beyond mind. You understand that much, even if your mind is not functioning, you will not die. There is something more in you. There is some more ingredients in you than mind. Than just the mind masala. That is, you are made to believe, or you are given that understanding from the young age. But with the Western mind, it is very difficult for them to understand. And you will really feel you are shaken. I am shaking what you think as you. Your identity is questioned. I am giving you the truth which shakes your very belief about your identity. Your very attachment with the identity. You can see in your life what all the dramas you are doing. Yes, next. All right, I'll do one thing. All of you finish talking, then I'll give the final. Because if I start talking, somehow by my nature, I don't stop. Orating, orating, orating. Yes. All of you finish, then I'll start. Yes.
The inner identity that you qualify, is it a function of a social environment?
Yes, yes, yes. That is the conscience. That is what I call conscience. Which you are carrying and struggling with which you are struggling, yes. Is conscience.
Is social environment, education, conditioning, is this all those elements that form?
These are all masala, ingredients which creates the conscience. Okay.
Thank you.
Next. Conscience is given to you by the people who don't follow their conscience. Because conscience as such cannot be followed. Even if you try to perfect it, there will be some impossible ideal. It will keep. It's like you run behind the ideal and the ideal is running behind something else. And both of you are chasing something which nobody knows. All of you know that story? Anybody who doesn't know that story? Oh, there are a few people. Just for them, I will tell the story. Three women died. And reached the Yama. Started inquiring to give the judgment. First lady came, asked, did you live a pure life? She said, yes, master, yes, lord, I lived a pure life. Even mentally, I have not done any mistake. I have lived such a beautiful, pure life. I saw his laptop, the record says, yes. Now they have computerized everything. Says, oh, all right. It's nice. You lived a pure life. Have the golden key. Go to the Swarga. Enjoy. First class. AC suit. Enjoy. She went away. Second lady came. Did you live a pure life? She put her head down. Master, physically I lived a pure life, but mentally I used to watch movies. So whenever I see the heroes, really I felt a little tempted. But physically I lived a pure life. I have never done anything wrong. First type the laptop, he saw the record. All right, at least you told the truth. You are honest. So, have the silver key. Go and enjoy. Second class. Third lady came. Asked, did you live a pure life? She put her head down. I was a dancer in nightclub and I have done whatever you can imagine and I have done whatever you can't imagine. I have done everything. She has put her head down. She says, now only you have to save me, Lord. I look this side and that side. Said, have my room key. I'll be there in few minutes. Be very clear. Whoever gives you conscience, they are giving their room keys. Whoever gives you conscience, they are all giving their room keys. Person who can hide his personal life from others, only they create conscience in you. Let it be very clear. Let you be very clear. See, creating impossible ideals is the best way to rule people. Once you create an impossible ideal and insert into his brain, create guilt, throughout his life he is a slave. Let me tell you, real morality will happen when you integrate yourself, not when you break yourself, not when you are schizophrenia. See, the morality of schizophrenia is not going to help you. You became schizophrenia. Let it be very clear, that is no way going to help you. That's why I tell you, conscience is poor substitute for consciousness.